Hello everybody, my name is Mari Kauramo and I'm super pleased to welcome and introduce Sanna Suvanto-Härsö. So let me start. Sanna has extensive experience in sales and marketing. She has been ranked as the most influenced woman in business, both in Denmark and in Finland. So I'm super pleased that you found some time from your very busy calendar today, Sanna, to be here with us. Welcome.
It sounds like you were talking about somebody else, but yeah,
I do
know these points, and yes, been around quite a lot, seen a lot, correct.
All right. My first question is that, hey, you are a chairman of very big, important, interesting companies. So what keeps you awake at night?
As a chairman, you have to keep yourself in the helicopter versus mm-hmm. the operative management. You know, the CEOs, the MDs and everybody, they're much more focused on, you know, operating the business. They are in operations. So what keeps me awake is very much about what will happen next year. What will happen next in 12 months? What will happen 18 months? So I can wake up middle of the night and saying, oh, grief, even if this company is going bad or good now, I have to, and the board has to look much further down and see about, you know, how are we really going to do in 18 months? So I can wake up and saying, oh, if the market is up or down in 18 months, that's what keeps me awake. The only way to plan for the future, even in 12 months time, in such an environment, is to make scenarios. It's, you know, doing one budget is stupid because that is one thing issue that won't happen. And for me, the big thing is you have to understand what's happening with your consumer, your customer. What's happening on that thing? If you don't understand what happens with your consumer or customer at the moment, what's going on their minds, what are they think they're going to do, then it doesn't matter what budget you do. It's all about top line. And I think people are very busy on concentrating on the, you know, SG&As and the fixed cost and things that are in the company because you feel you can control them. But the only kind of thing that brings money into the company, it's the consumer, the customer, whoever is bringing in. And understanding what's on their heads is extremely important. It's all about understanding how does the consumer or customer, if it's a B2B customer, how do they see themselves? In order for you to be able to think, what is your business all about?
Sometimes we also see that maybe in the boardroom, there are people who are hesitant to take the next steps and maybe are even a little bit afraid of having bold moves. What is hindering, what is stopping companies and some of the top managers to really start transforming before they are forced to transform?
I've never heard anybody of any of the project, of anything they have done to say, we did it too early. You know, if it's a people you have to change, what you always say, oh God, why didn't we do this earlier? When you finally do it, you're like, grief, we should have done this earlier. And I think it's a part of the humans, we're afraid of the risk. We know what we have, we don't know what we don't have.
You have such a vast, long experience. But what is the one thing or something that you would like to mention that has changed you as a leader?
I enjoy having to solve problematic businesses. And I think that has given me more guts, if I put it this way. You know, I don't get afraid as easy anymore because I've seen some really I've seen some really big troubles. And that, I think, specifically today's world, I was in the middle of the crisis as a board person in the after the 08 crisis. And listen, the sun will come up. It will get better. But it's like biking. Don't stop pedaling. Keep working. Keep focusing. And it will get better.
What about the people aspect? You know, you as a leader, you are also leading people. You know, you need to make sure that they are motivated and you know, they are following you. Any experiences that you or tips that you would like to share, especially for the ones who are just starting as new managers?
The issue is that if you don't know yourself where you want to go with your project, with your business, with your company, whatever responsibility you have, nobody will follow you. So it all starts by leading yourself, sit down, make the analysis, figure out where you want to go. I think that's one aspect. But on that one, I think the key thing is if you try to, you know, we all look for role models and we look for people doing something. But if you try to be somebody else than you are, you can fail. If you have figured out where you want to go, and then you want to take the others with you. If you're trying to be somebody else than yourself, you're going to fail big time. I mean, all communication is, I mean, over 70% of communication is nonverbal. So it doesn't matter what you say. But if you have the determination and it's visible and it's you can hear it, then people will follow you. You follow people emotionally. We might think that we are rational, but we follow people emotionally.
I love it. Thank you for your time, Sanna. So let's keep dreaming big. Let's keep planning. It has been my pleasure once again to spend time with you.
Thank you for inviting me.